Hi, my name is Heather Slusser with the University of Wisconsin Extension in Marathon County. Today, I would like to talk with you about sampling hay and interpreting your hay analysis report. The key to successful hay analysis is taking a good representative hay sample on the farm. A representative sample of hay needs to be taken from every hay lot. A lot of hay is the hay harvested within one day from one field or from a specific variety or hybrid. A hay bale is not uniform in composition. Due to variation among bales from the same lot, it is important to sample 20 small rectangular bales or 8 to 10 large bales. The best place to core sample small rectangular bales is through the center of one end. Medium and large square bales do not vary in distribution of leaves and stems across the ends as small square bales do, so they can be sampled any place on the bale end or side at a 45 degree angle to the side. Round bales should be sampled perpendicular to the circumference of the bale. Using a core sampler is better than taking a grab sample because it causes less separation of leaves and stems. To take a sample, follow the following procedure. First, you want to test each hay lot separately. Take 15 to 20 widely separated cores or samples from each lot. Use a bale corer to reduce error. The core sampler works with either a variable speed half-inch drill or a hand brace. Insert the core sampler at a 90-degree angle into the center of the end of a small square bale. Mix the cores in a clean pail. Then place the entire sample in a clean plastic bag or other container and seal tightly. Make sure you label the container with the farm name, address, a sample number. Don't forget to add the forage type, such as alfalfa, alfalfa timothy, red clover, and also add the variety. Complete the feed and forage information sheet and mail your sample to the Soil and Forage Analysis Lab in Marshfield. For more information on sampling hay, silage, and total mixed rations for analysis, please refer to the fact sheet A2309. Once you receive your forage analysis report from the Soil and Forage Analysis Laboratory, you need to determine if your hay will meet the cow's needs for the wintertime. To do this, you first want to determine the expected dry matter intake of your animal. If the herd average is 1,500 pounds, then the dry matter intake is 32 pounds per day, or about 2% of the animal's body weight. The next step is to determine if the hay will meet the animal's crude protein requirements. Dry, far-off cows need 9.9% crude protein, or 3.2 pounds of crude protein per day. Our hay, in this example, has 19.2% crude protein, or 6.14 pounds of crude protein per day. This means the cows will receive adequate crude protein from this hay sample. You also need to determine if the hay will meet the energy requirements of the cow. Dry, far-off cows need 61.9% total digestible nutrients, or 19.8 pounds of total digestible nutrients per day. Our hay, in this example, has 52.25% TDN, or 16.72 pounds of total digestible nutrients per day. This is 3.08 pounds of total digestible nutrients less than what the cows need on a daily basis. This means that to meet the energy requirements of the cow, energy will need to be supplemented to this hay. In the next part of this video, we will estimate how much hay is needed to get us through the wintertime. The first step in this process is to convert dry matter intake to as-fed intake. The hay in our example is 82.78% dry matter. So in order to feed our cattle 32 pounds of dry matter per day, we need to feed them 38.7 pounds of hay per day. The next step is to determine how much hay is needed for the winter. This is determined by the number of animals you will be feeding and the number of days you will be feeding them. In this example, we are feeding 20 cows for 150 days. This means that we will need at least 58.05 tons of hay. However, this is not the amount of hay we will need for the winter, because there is always loss. The amount of loss can range from 4 to 50%. In this example, we will assume there is 20% loss. This means we will need to plan for an additional 11.62 tons of hay, or a total of 69.7 tons of hay to get us through the winter time. If you have beef cattle and would like to run the same analysis, please see the Hay Analysis Guide for Beef Cattle, written by Amy Redunz and Jean Schrieffer. Thank you for watching this video, and we hope you learned something.